Hey, welcome to this week's episode of Lunker Junkies TV. How was that trip up on the Kenai there, buddy?
Yeah, it was awesome. You know, you guys are going to absolutely enjoy this episode. I'm fishing with Brandon from BNR Tackle, and again, fishing the soft beads. This time we're on the lower Kenai. No guides, just a bunch of really fun guys, and we're rolling the soft beads. These guys were dedicated hardcore to the hard bead style. We got them all to switch it over, try out the soft bead, and by the end of the day, they're screaming, get soft. We're having a blast.
It looked like they were getting pretty excited about that soft bead take.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, it was absolutely on fire. We're rolling the size 10s, some of the 8s, some 12s, and, you know, they're rolling strike indicators with fly rods. On the Chetco, elk, and the Coquille, I like to bobber dog it. In fact,
right.
Got an article in the December 2016 issue, talks about rigging the soft beads in Northwest Sportsman Magazine.
Great article, check that out.
Yeah, I appreciate that. So, talks about how I rig the soft beads and how to fish them down here out of Oregon, but for you guys up in Alaska that are die-hard, hard-beat fishermen, just leave the hard beads at home, leave the nail polish at home. Give BNR Tackle soft bead a shot, you will not be disappointed. So,
and for those of you that haven't used them, the whole point of the soft bead is that they hold on to it longer. It feels natural to them. They're not biting some hard object that feels foreign. And it's money. I mean, it'll land so many more fish than the hard bead will.
Yeah, and you know what's funny is when Brandon first started doing this, again, he was the only one. He came up with this whole concept. He came up with the holy worm, came up with the soft bead, and there's been some imitators out there right now that are trying it. But Brandon's got all the sizes at BNR Tackle. He's got all the colors.
He's already done all the trial and error.
Yeah, and his beads actually, they're hollow. They're built like a hard bead.
And they're neutral buoyant.
That's right.
That's another important feature about them. They're neutral buoyant, so they don't sink, they don't rise. They're almost like a levitating bait. They float real natural.
They float real nice off the bottom. So anyways, check it out, BNR Tackle Soft Bead, and check out this episode coming up. There's a lot of tips flying in the air, a lot of hooting and hollering. It's a good time.
Stay tuned. We'll be right back with some more Lunker Junkies TV.
It's on!
Salmon shark! Salmon shark!
Yeah,
what do you say?
Oh. It's a real quality fish here.
What a trophy, huh?
Oh, look at that.
We just got into a big bunch of fish. Jen's fighting one right now.
Whoa! Real beast.
Lunker Junkies TV is brought to you by Bimark. Get ready for your season for less. Procure Bait Sense and Cures, ruthlessly effective. Lamaglass Rods, fish with confidence. Yakima Bait Company, home of the rooster tail. Shasta Tackle, inventor of the sling blade. Bait Buttons, because presentation matters. BNR Tackle, inventor of the steelhead holy worm. Northwest Sportsman Magazine, chock full of tips, tricks, and useful information. Fish Seward, Alaska, an Oregon fishing adventure. Power Drifter Boats, The Real Tech, and Hypnotic Customs Design and Graphics.
Minutes in this morning, first fish, big fish of the day, about a 10 millimeter modeled peach bead. Looks pretty big.
27 inches long.
27 inches. We're getting a girth measurement and it is
16 around.
27 by 16. What's the weight on that? 's Mike from Alaska Fly Fishing Goods. We just banged a 27-inch fish, and Mike couldn't wait to get back on the river, so he just had to get one off the back of the boat. I think we're going to just leave him on the island here the rest of the day, and we'll go up the rest of the river.
I can do that, man. I can hang out here all day.
Is that on the soft beat too?
It's on soft beat, 10 mil.
All right, 10 mil prototype colors coming through.
Yeah, and if you take that bag of beads I gave you, it'd be really soft beads.
Yeah, I got it. The water feels surprisingly warm, maybe because it's so freaking cold. We're on the lower Kenai today, down below Centennial. We just made our first drift. We're heading back up to start in again. We've been fishing some prototype beads, kind of a creamsicle bead and a 10 millimeter. We got a really big fish the first pass. It looks like we're gonna head back up and see if we get another big fish. Kind of the mist is just coming off the river. A little fall early time, nice and cold. It's gonna be a good day.
Dude, this is...
Soft beads are killing it today. Beautiful Kenai River.
Alaska's gem. Just amazing. Love this place.
So we're gonna tuck in right behind this corner here.
I'm Mike with Alaska Fly Fishing Goods, and today I'm fishing the mighty Kenai River with Brandon and the guys from B&R Tackle. We're fishing soft beads, fishing the 10 mil peach, and they are railing trout left and right. It's phenomenal, absolutely phenomenal.
Nice, we're killing it today. There we go. It's about mid-morning. Oh, there's a fish!
So this is what they call a guide release tool. It is, this one's just made out of a welding rod and a cork. It's got a figure four as the release, kind of a triangle. It's been soldered off, rounded off so it doesn't catch the line. And all you do is in a bead rig, is it catches and you pull, catch the hook, turn it 90 degrees away, it pops the hook right out. Especially if the hook's barbless, comes out real easy. Real nice and easy on the fish, don't have to touch them. Money.
Fish Wash Friday. Whew. This is Brandon from B&R Tackle. Today we're up fishing in Alaska on the Kenai. And we've been working really hard the last 4 or 5 months developing a trout bead line, kind of an extension of the soft bead line that we've been so successful with for the steelhead market in Alaska. And there's a kind of a series of eggs or a series of beads we need to develop for the soft bead line, and it's a series of live eggs and dead eggs. And in this box here, you can see we have some of our standard colors, and then additionally, you'll see the prototype numbers. So these are basically all the prototype colors that we've shot and we've been working on. And then we worked with some of the top guides, and Mike Cole from Alaska Fly Fishing Goods, and he's going to talk a little bit about some of the color selections we have here.
You know, so we've been trying to develop a lineup of good colors for fishing for trout and char behind spawning kings, sockeye, pinks, and going everything from, you know, your nice live eggs, your peachy colors, which are more your chum eggs and stuff like that, to your more red, your sockeye, your oranges, which are more king eggs, and in sizes 6 mil, 8 mil, 10 mil, up to 12. And part of the what we're trying to look at in some of these beads, you'll see, you know, they're the 50-50 bead where they're kind of milked out on one side, where it kind of mimics an egg that's been sitting on one side of in the gravel, one side up, one side down, and finally get washed out, and they'll still have that kind of nice fresh look on one side and a dead look on the other side. Then you got your mottled beads. You know, these are the ones that the membranes are really starting to whiten up on. Fish really key in on those at certain times. We also got your kind of your more live looking beads, you know, ones with kind of some nice sheen to them, you know, stuff that looks like it's just fresh out of the salmon. Just trying to, you know, come up with a good bead color for every and size for every situation you may come across in the trout world here in Alaska, just like you would with the hard beads.
Yeah. And, we've been prototyping and testing them up here for the last couple of days in Alaska. The results have been pretty outstanding. We've had the first couple of days we've probably had 10 to 15 fish, and today's been the big fish day. We've had probably 10 probably 20 inch plus fish, including a big 27 inch fish right out of the gate this morning, almost all of them on soft beads. And it's been a great day testing and prototyping, and I think we really got a winner here, and this is gonna make a big difference for you.
Dirty.
Touching lots of bombs.
Awesome. Camera boat's hooking up. Nice fish.
Super! Well, we're ready. We've been ready. Oh, dang. That's a dandy. Oh, chunky monkey right there.
Shake and bake that thing. Shake it.
And then you bake it.
Beautiful.
Then you bake
it. I just blew your mind.
Power of the sandwich.
You sandwiching?
No, I mean, I ate the sandwich already, dude.
Oh, maybe you're sandwiching me.
Mike here with Alaska Fly Fishing Goods. I'm fishing the Kenai with B&R Tackle. We are fishing their soft beads. And the rig I'm using today is a 10'6" switch rod. I am using the Airflow switch float line, 390 grain. Off of this, we're fishing about a 10-foot leader. So off the end of my floating line, I've got a little butt section, about 40-pound test, where I'm gonna use my indicator. From there, I'm fishing about 8 to 9 feet of 15-pound fluorocarbon, going to a nail knot where I've put my soft putty for my weight, or you could use split shot. And then we're using a peach colored 10 mil soft bead, going to a nail knot with a tag, 40-pound Maxima, using the tag as the stopper. Going to number 6, octopus hook snelled.
Some people call it Dougal.
Dang, that's a good one.
Oh, that's good. Got a big old boy? I ain't no pink, dude. It wouldn't run like that. Fire up there.
I know. My
you got a trout or what, huh?
Soft beads.
All right, let's get another one.
Best decision of the day, switching to the 8 mil.
I feel like I told you it was gonna be.
Yeah.
I feel like I verbatim said this is gonna be the game changer for you.
Ready?
Yeah.
Oh, my bad.
Good shot.
Thank you.
I really hope you enjoyed this week's episode. You know, we've had Brandon from B&R Tackle be a sponsor on the show now for going on a year. We've shot some amazing steelhead episodes. Last year, Rocky and I and Jennifer were on the upper Kenai, drifting the soft bead. Brandon's been working on this for a while now. These new products that are coming out this year, you gotta check them out. Any of you guys that are either steelhead fishing or bead fishing, whether you're on the Kenai in Alaska or all the way down Bobberdoggin in Southern Oregon, you gotta try them out. B&R Tackle Soft Beads, two thumbs up. We actually gave some to some guys at the boat ramp today. I wish that I had video while they were hooting and hollering and thanking us. That's just how it works out there. So check it out, B&R Tackles and the soft bead. So did you guys have a great time?
Get soft!
Get soft! All right, keep your tip up. Hope to see you out on the water. Have a great day.
Lunker Junkies TV is brought to you by Bi-Mart. Get ready for your season for less. Pro-Cure Bait Sense and Cures, ruthlessly effective. Lamaglass Rods, fish with confidence. Yakima Bait Company, home of the rooster tail. Shasta Tackle, inventor of the sling blade. Bait Buttons, because presentation matters. B&R Tackle, inventor of the steelhead holy worm. Northwest Sportsman Magazine, chock full of tips, tricks, and useful information. Fish Seward, Alaska, an Oregon fishing adventure. Power Drifter Boats, The Real Tech, and Hypnotic Customs Design and Graphics.
Born to be fishermen, we were born to be fishermen, so come along with me on Lunker Junkies. On Lunker Junkies.